Welcome back. Today we've been sent a case. I'm a little confused by it. It says, "Could you review this plan for me? I did this case as an immediate, and after placing the implant, I noticed it was placed too far or angled too much mesially. I took the implant out and grafted the site and will place it again in 4 months. Afterwards, I reviewed the plan and think my mistake was planning the occlusal plane." And that Planning the occlusal plane. I'm trying to figure out mistakes. My mistake. Thanks for the input. So, as you can see here, there are two plans. This is the plan for the guide that was ordered, and this is a plan, corrected plan for the implant. So, we'll do a couple of different types of evaluations here. I do have a couple of quick questions on this case. I'm a little confused by when the scan was taking and when the 3D scan was taken, when the CEREC scan was taken. And the reason I ask that is in the 3D scan, in the X-ray, in the Galileo's image, we have a tooth in site number 30. But on the CEREC scan, we don't have a tooth in site number 30. So I don't I'm a little off from there. Although that doesn't affect overall the plan or the verification or integrity of the data, although if we take a, it doesn't affect the data. Although the only thing I can see here is the tooth seems to be a little bit more lingual to the proposed tooth, but that could be a lingual-verted tooth and they're bringing it out to the buccal. But yeah, nonetheless, I just kind of wanted to make that comment there. So let's take a look at the original plan. So let's make the assumption again that this was done with guided surgery. Again, my question is on this tissue here. This just doesn't seem to be the correct tissue as an immediate case. So there's several different questions that we have to look at here. One is what could have caused this to happen? The other thing is also, why did this happen? What caused this to happen? And also, was this a good case for immediate? So I'd like to start there. Is what could have caused this to happen? So if we truly used a guide here, what could cause this to go off course, which is what it sounds like happened? The guide could be seated incorrectly, and the pilot or the osteotomy was done off angle. Number two, what I see more often is there's a desire for dentists to use not fully guided systems because the implants are less expensive. In this particular case, we're using this dentist is using the implant direct system. While it's a wonderful implant and does a nice, very nice job, has great success rates. My concern with implant direct for guided surgery is that it's not guided surgery. It, in fact, is guided osteotomy with hand placement of the implant. And in these soft bone situations, especially in a case like this where we have infection, even though you drill your osteotomy here, for example, and let me do some drawings here to project. So let's say we actually did get the osteotomy drilled right here. And all of this bone is very soft in my squiggly line area. When you go to hand place this implant, it's going to have a tendency, let me do this in a different color. It's going to have a tendency, the implant's going to have a tendency, while you may start it here, to go to the path of least resistance and kind of create its own new path, like so. So this is why I'm a big fan of using true guided surgery, where there's a mount that fits into the sleeve that will control the trajectory of the implant as well. Again, Implant Direct is a good implant company. They make good implants. They are certainly very cost effective, but there are limitations in terms of what you can do with their implants when it comes to guided surgery. So I would encourage Implant Direct to make a implant mount that works with a guided sleeve to make things a little bit more predictable. So hopefully that helps understands that, and we can take a look here. Also, the occlusal plane is definitely off in this particular case. Is it significantly off? Not really. That's not terribly off there. So, I would say if anything, we could have this level down a little bit more, but I'm not overly worried about our occlusal plane in this particular case. I do think that the implant is probably placed a little bit buccal because I'm not quite certain that I trust this Xeric design, so I would probably have tilted this implant a little bit to the lingual. So, just 2 cents there. Here is the new plan that was done. So this one is a little bit better in terms of the occlusal plane. It's much more flat. If anything, maybe a little bit of a correction like that, but hardly any. But again, I still question the upper, the location of the implant from that perspective. The other thing I would say here is, based on how much space we have in the bone right here, if we take a closer look, we can see that, our bone looks roughly like so, and I have X amount of space here, but so little space here. I don't like leaving that plate so thin. So if anything, I would have moved this implant to the buccal and then tilted it back to the lingual to get me a little bit more bone thickness on the lingual there. So enough commentary there on the implant itself. I want to do focus some attention on doing this case as an immediate placement. So for that, I'd like to go to the panorama view. The first thing I certainly notice in this case, and it causes concern for many people looking at this, is the amount of infection around tooth number 30. Infection is not necessarily say that you can't place the implant. The key with infection is to clean the infection, to totally clean the infection, get all of the infection out of there, all of the semi-infected or soft bone, get all of that curetted out. The bigger key with this type of infection is what is going on with the buccal plate. And if we take a much closer view of this, we can see that there looks to be, based on the amount of infection here, a breakage. There looks to be a breakage in the buccal plate right here. Again, hindsight is 20/20. Being able to do this without having the benefit of seeing the patient, I would question the predictiveness of doing this as an immediate placement. I would probably have elected to take this tooth out, curette and clean, and maybe graft at that time, or even possibly come back and graft 6 weeks later after the body has cleaned out the infection based on how well I could clean out the infection at the time extraction. But I really have concerns about the lack of buccal wall on this mesial, which would also lend my theory that I talked about at the beginning, which was that this implant was placed into soft bone, and that since there's soft bone, hand driving the implant in place allowed the implant to drift to the mesial. So hopefully that makes sense. Thank you for submitting this case.